Daniel Mollier, hello.
Hello.
You are innovation manager of Texol. It's a French engineering company. You are currently vice chair of the European Solar Thermal Technology Platform, and you are operating agent of the IEA Solar Heating and Cooling Program, a research program which is dealing with new generation of solar heating and cooling systems. Our conference takes place in Abu Dhabi, which is in the Gulf States, and I think these countries use about 50 to 60% of their electricity for cooling. So what is your recommendation to change that?
Mm-hmm. Solar energy, of course, is a very, very accurate option to cover these cooling needs. It's even one of the only possibility for renewables. And then for that, when you have said that, in Europe, we have technical solution. But the biggest priority at the moment is to adapt solar cooling solution for these special conditions. So there are several subtopics which could be and which will be storage, adaptability against the harsh conditions, maintenance, very easy maintenance, unbreakable systems. That's really the main priority for solar cooling in the MENA region.
We have solar thermal-driven cooling systems and solar PV-driven cooling systems. What is the difference and what is more suitable for these countries?
Mm-hmm. The difference is solar thermal is directly producing heat to drive chillers or different technology, transform into cooling. And the second is you produce electricity and then you use this electricity to drive compressors, chillers, air conditioners. And the second question is very simple. The best will win. There is not at all any evident choice, depend on the size, depend on the situation, and depend on the efficiency and the simplicity of the final solution.
We know that air conditioning makes peaks in the grid. So you have always a certain lunch peak and you also have an evening peak. How does your technologies react to that? It might be also a challenge to get these peaks further down.
Exactly. One of the first is, of course, the hanging fruits are the building where the load is corresponding at best with the irradiation curve, the solar input. But of course,
these are office buildings.
Yes, office. But in the majority of the offices as well, so air conditioning need is all day long, and even with a peak at the end of the day. But in this condition, that's why I referred in the beginning of our speech, this is storage, and thermal storage is really a very good one. But cold storage is really a very interesting issue for this area.
So you have done, you have published studies, yes. You have made assessments. How were your information received in these countries?
It was 2 years ago, and it's accessible still on the website solarthermal.world.com. In the beginning, 2 years ago, it was really a good ideas. But maybe a little bit too early, because the financial situation and the energy situation was not this, what we have now. But now, probably in a lot of these countries, in this region, there is an urgent need to export the maximum of oil possible, or gas, or energy, and not to use so much internally this energy. And then, in this area, it's really compulsory to find solution, alternative solution, sustainable solution to cover big needs. And one of the biggest needs, as you said, is air conditioning.
So there is already activities going on in these countries to develop their own technologies, or you're thinking technology transfer from Europe will be a good solution?
Yes, technology transfer is really, I think now, becoming very accurate, with the big caution to make it smoothly and really to create a very deep and serious cooperation with a real transfer technology, so that local very good institutes and even companies, they can really, yes, take it and make it really long-term reliable. And again, the key word is for this area is to make unbreakable systems, very robust, very performant on the long run, because it must be sustainable.
So this gathering of more than 500 researchers from all around the world and Gulf experts, is this an important mean to transport this knowledge?
Of course. This is, I hope, the beginning of a big story. And some signs show that it could be the case.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.